Welcome to the Health Bulletin. Across the globe, we've tracked the emergence of mysterious illnesses, unusual health phenomena, and groundbreaking medical discoveries. But guess what? There's so much more to explore, and we don't want you to miss a single update. Today, we delve into the specifics of a scenario analysis by Johns Hopkins, featured in part two of our SPARS series. In 2017, they shared a paper discussing an event called the SPARS Pandemic, which is predicted to happen between 2025 and 2028, sort of like a simulation. Remember, this was a futuristic fictional scenario about a potential coronavirus that sweeps across the world sometime in the future 2025-2028. Imagine a world hit by a pandemic, not COVID-19, but SPARS, a fictional virus from the future. This story, written by the Johns Hopkins Center for Health Security, takes us on a journey from 2025 to 2028. Beginning in St. Paul, Minnesota, it's called St. Paul Acute Respiratory Syndrome, or SPARS for short. Before we move forward, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and join our Health Bulletin community. Why? Because subscribing not only supports the channel, but ensures you're always in the loop with the latest health trends, news, and tips that matter to you. Plus, it's completely free. Now let's return to our topic for today. How SPARS presents challenges to the world. That feels strangely familiar, echoing recent pandemic events. Before the real-world pandemic, this scenario was a mere exercise in preparedness. It's a deep dive into a future where a new coronavirus tests humanity. As many parts of it closely resembled the response to COVID-19, which sparked curiosity and discussion. In October 2025, a concerning outbreak emerged in St. Paul, Minnesota, linked to three deaths at the First Baptist Church. Two victims had returned from aiding flood victims in the Philippines, and the third was a relative of another churchgoer who had also been to the Philippines, initially thought to be a severe flu outbreak. Tests ruled out influenza, leading to confusion among health officials. The mystery deepened until the CDC identified the cause as a novel coronavirus named SARS-CoV, marking the beginning of the SPARS outbreak. As cases quickly spread across Minnesota and other states, the CDC and health officials scrambled to understand and contain the virus by emphasizing on hygiene and urging those with severe symptoms to seek care. The timing was critical, with the Thanksgiving holiday and Black Friday shopping looming, potentially accelerating the spread. Despite these efforts, public concern grew due to the virus's apparent severity, with early reports focusing on the most severe cases requiring hospitalization. However, it soon became clear that SPARS had unique characteristics, which complicating its containment, an extended incubation period allowed for asymptomatic transmission and certain groups, including children, pregnant women, and those with chronic respiratory conditions, faced higher risks. Initially, the SPARS case fatality rate was estimated at 4.7%, but this was later adjusted to 0.6% as more data on milder cases became available, highlighting the challenges in managing and understanding new viral outbreaks. In St. Paul, a pressing question looms. If not the flu, what is it? It's not just a virus, it's a puzzle, challenging everything we thought we knew about contagion and control. Nonetheless, I think it is worthwhile to take a look at this document, mainly because it helps to ask the right questions. Regardless of whether or not you believe in the similarities of SPARS and COVID-19, early in the SPARS pandemic, public health and medical professionals were hopeful that the outbreak could be contained through case identification and isolation. It quickly became clear, however, that this strategy was not as effective as initially hoped. With no treatments or vaccines initially available, the world scrambles. This scenario isn't just a story, it's a prompt to ask critical questions, to ponder our responses to unforeseen threats. Is SPARS a preview of challenges to come, or a guide on how to, or not to, navigate future crises? If you haven't come across this document before, prepare for more than just a reading experience. It's a dive into the intriguing world of what-ifs. Thanks for watching. Your health, our mission. Remember, staying informed is the first step towards a healthier life. So what are you waiting for? Hit that like and subscribe button and let's make health a priority together. See you in the next video.